Good morning. Good morning. Lift me up. Lift me up. In the power of your name, you lift me up. Glory to God. Glory to God. Welcome this morning to Fourth Watch Prayer. I pray that you had a good night's sleep and rest. Hope like no other. Good morning, Stephanie. Good morning. We have other people joining us. I can't see their names. Good morning, Sister Yvette. We're coming from Job 42 this morning. Glory to God. God, we thank you for being our peace. We thank you, God, that your peace reaches us, God. We thank you, God, your strength. Hallelujah, God. Thank you for the fullness of time, God. We wait. Hallelujah, the power. The power of your name. Hallelujah. You lift us up, God, and we thank you. We thank you for lifting us up. Hallelujah. Thank you for lifting us up, God. Thank you for lifting us up in your hand. Thank you for hope this morning. Thank you for grace this morning. Thank you for love this morning. Thank you, thank you, thank you for peace this morning. Thank you for the power of your name. You lift us up, God. So we call on the name that you have given us, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Thank you for Jesus this morning. Thank you for Jesus, our keeper. Thank you for Jesus, our Savior. Thank you for Jesus, our Lord. Thank you for Jesus, our King of Kings and our Lord of Lords. Thank you for Jesus, our peace, God. Thank you for Jesus, our provider. Thank you for Jesus, our healer. Thank you for Jesus this morning. Thank you for Jesus this morning. Hallelujah, God. Let someone who needs to call upon his name find peace in that name. Find joy in that name. Find healing in that name. Find restoration in that name. God, we thank you. Find reconciliation in that name, oh God. Hallelujah, we thank you, God. We bless your name this morning. Thank you that we heard our names called, oh God. Thank you that you said Tuesday, you said Yvette, you said Stephanie, you said Tracy, you said all those who will come on this morning to hear what the Spirit of the Lord has to say to them, the church, God. We thank you. We thank you, God. It reaches. It reaches to us, oh God, and we thank you this morning. We love you, God. Reaches to me. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord this morning, our King, our Lord, our God, our Daddy. Strength like no other. Thank you for being our strength, oh God. Thank you, God, that when we are weak, we are made strong through you. Thank you that we can put our hope and our faith and our trust in you this morning. God, we come in agreement with every need, God, that you will meet every need. We come in agreement this morning that you will meet every need according to your riches and glory. Hallelujah, God, because you sit high and you look low. You know every need of every person under the sound of my voice. You know every need of every person that will watch this this morning, Fourth Watch Prayer and Power Teaching, God. You know their need, God. You know the desires of their heart. God, we thank you, God. We ask that the fullness of time come into their lives right now for the thing they've been praying for days, for weeks, for months, yea, even years, oh God. Manifest, oh God, manifest. Let this day, why not this day, be the day? Hallelujah. Why not this week be the week? Why not this month be the month? Why not this month be the year, oh God? We trust you, God. Hallelujah, Lord. We trust you with our dreams. We trust you with our visions. We trust you with our purpose, because it's your purpose for our life. It's your plan. God, we trust you this morning. Hallelujah. We trust you with our lives, oh God. We trust you with our children. We trust you with our spouses. Hallelujah. We trust you, God. We trust you to know what's best, oh God. Help us to obey you even when it hurts. Help us to obey you even when it hurts, Daddy. We love you this morning. We plead the blood over our lives and over our health and over our bodies and over our jobs and over our children and over our spouses, God. We thank you for the blood this morning. It reaches. It flows and it reaches. It reaches. It reaches high. Hallelujah. Thank you for the blood, God. Thank you for the blood that flows. Thank you for the blood that covers. Thank you for the blood that protects. Thank you for the blood this morning. Thank you for the blood that heals. Thank you for the power of your blood this morning. The power of your name. All we need is your name and your blood. All we need is your name and the blood. Hallelujah. Thank you this morning. Glory to God. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I am convinced this morning that nothing can separate me from the love of God. I am convinced this morning. Anybody convinced? Nothing can separate us from the love of God this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Nothing will separate you from the love of God this morning. Be convinced this morning. Not death. Hallelujah. Not life, not angels, not demons, not this life or the life to come, not the present, not the future. Hallelujah. No power, no principality, nothing in the spiritual realm that is ungodly. Good morning, June. Nothing. I am convinced. I am convinced that nothing will separate me. Good morning, Sister Bernice. Nothing will separate me from the love of God. Not height, not death, not width. Nothing in all creation, in the earth, above the earth. I am convinced this morning that nothing can separate me from the love of my God. Hallelujah. From his covering and from his protection. Nothing can separate me from the love of God. Hallelujah. That comes through my relationship with Jesus Christ. Nothing. Nothing. Nothing can separate you. You got to be convinced of this. Short of you walking out from underneath the covering of Jesus Christ, you saying, I don't believe, I'm sick of this Christian thing, hallelujah, I'm sick of church, I'm sick of church people. Oh my God, if I hear another Christian say they sick of church people, then that means you sick of yourself. You sick of yourself. The church is full of sick people. That's why it's the church. My God. Hallelujah. Hey, God. That's why you there. Ha ha. Glory to God. Because we need help. The one to the right of you, the left of you, in front of you, behind you. We all need help. That's why we are in the house of God every Sunday and prayerfully Bible study. You got to be convinced this morning. You got to be convinced of the love of God this morning. You got to be convinced. You got to be convinced. You got to be convinced that you won't be like Lot's wife and put your hand to it and turn back. And God says, oh, you're going to be like a pillar of salt. You ever had salt? You ever had salt get hard in a container? It's of no use. And I think people say you can like put a little water in there or something. But now you didn't water down the effectiveness of the salt. Because you looking back at weak and miserable ways, you got to be convinced that he who began a good work in you has promised to complete it until the returning of the Lord. You got to be convinced this morning. You got to be convinced that the promises and the prophecies that God has spoken over your life will come to pass. You got to be convinced. I know it's taken longer than you thought. I know by now you thought this would have happened or that would have happened. I know, I understand. But God said, I had a couple of other things I was going to speak on this morning, and I kept vacillating, but all that kept coming to me, you got to be convinced. You got to be convinced. You got to be convinced to the point that you will not turn back to weak and miserable ways. You got to be convinced. You got to be convinced. Now, I'm not talking about convincing yourself of what your faith says. I'm talking about for convincing yourself of what the Spirit of the Lord has said to you. Glory to God this morning. You must be convinced. You must be convinced that what God has promised you according to His Word, according to His Word, not according to your emotions, but according to His Word, because God Almighty, it's falling apart. According to His Word, you must be convinced. What has the Lord said to you? What did He say to you? Go back to Romans chapter 8. Go back to Romans chapter 8, starting about verse 38. That I am convinced that nothing will separate me. Good morning, Sister Johnson. Nothing will separate me. Nothing. But where I got stuck yesterday, it blessed my soul so much. Where I got stuck was Job. Good morning, Pumpkin, Sister Alicia, baby. Job chapter 42, if you got your Bibles turned there. It's going to bless you. It's going to bless you. Yes, it will. Because it just blessed my socks. Blessed me right on up out of them. Now, I want to read two different versions. I'm going to read the Message and Amplified, I believe. I believe I'm going to read both, if the Lord allows me. Okay. So this is what the Lord says. This is what the word of the Lord says. Job replied to the Lord. Now, in Job chapter 41, this is where... good morning, Brother Tony. This is where Job and God are having this conversation about what God has done. So if you know, Job chapter 41, just kind of scroll down to the bottom. And we're just going to walk through this real quick and just hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to you this morning. You must be convinced. There's no shadow of turning in this thing with God. In this season, you must be convinced. I don't care what's going on with number 45 in the White House, in the Senate, in Congress, in Congress. I don't care. I don't care what's going on. And neither does God, because you must be convinced. Ah, glory to God, that the government is up on God's shoulders. You got to be convinced this morning. You got to be convinced. It doesn't matter. I know what's going on in our cities with shootings and killings and what might be going on in your family and in your marriage and in relationships and on your job, but you got to be convinced that God has promised never to leave you and never forsake you. You got to be convinced. What is it that Sister Tuesday keeps doing? I keep going back to the Word. You got to keep going back to the Word, because you can be what will convince you. And what will allow you to stay fast, unmovable, so that you can abound in the work of the Lord, is that you must be convinced of what God has told you. You got to be convinced this morning. I look at things that are that God has given me the assignment to do. God has called me to do. God has told me to do. That, I'm going to be honest, I didn't want to do it. I don't know why all y'all who saved and got calls on y'all life act like y'all was happy about it. I'm happy about it now. but I wasn't happy about it in the beginning. I didn't want nothing to do with this. I didn't. But God said, I was doing perfectly fine in corporate America, making six figures, traveling all over the world. But God gave me an unrest. He gave me an unrest, and that unrest pushed me and propelled me into what my purpose was, which is to minister the gospel of Jesus Christ. You must be convinced. This is the only reason why I have not turned back after 20 years and haven't seen consistently my six figures. You got to be convinced that what you gave up, God is going to return. You must be convinced. You got to be convinced that what He promised you, He is faithful to do. I'm convinced that if I wait on God and have been waiting on God the right way, good God Almighty, for almost 20 years for my husband to come. It ain't been easy. It's been His grace. It's been His grace, but I've waited, and because of that, I'm convinced. He's been my husband man since the moment I confessed Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord, and He will continue to be. But you got to be convinced. You got to be convinced about what's in this word. Not your feelings, not your emotions, not what you see, not how you feel about something. You got to be convinced. Not because mama said it, grandmama said it, your daddy said it, your pastor said it. Thank God for our pastors. But you got to be convinced of this word. This is the word that will not return void. It must go and accomplish what it's been sent to do. You got to be convinced this morning. So, Job chapter 42 says, Job chapter 42 says that Job responds to God. I mean, my God, ooh, that's a privilege right there, that he even gets to respond to God. Hallelujah. And he responds to God and he says, I am convinced. You can do anything and everything, and nothing or no one can upset or change your plans, oh mighty God. Woo! I'm convinced. I'm convinced, oh God, first of all, that you are God, that you are Elohim, that you are Jehovah Jireh, that you are Jehovah Nissi, that you are Jehovah Tiskanu. I am convinced that you are the great I am convinced. I am convinced that nothing can separate me from your love, short of me walking out from underneath your covering and saying that you do not exist. We will not deny the existence of the Holy Spirit and the power of the Holy Spirit. We will not do that, and we must be convinced that God is God and Jesus is Jesus and the Holy Spirit is Holy Spirit, and these three are one, according to John, 1 John. Oh, we must be convinced this morning, and we must not shrink back. We must not go back to weak and miserable ways, according to Galatians. Oh, no, I will not go back. I will not go back. I'm convinced. The Bible says in Hebrews, I think about verse 4, it says, for you to now look back, and I'm paraphrasing, and act as if what Jesus did didn't happen. The Bible says something like, you put him back on the cross. Well, my God, you got to be convinced of the cross this morning. You got to be convinced of the cross. You got to be convinced that the blood did it. You must be convinced. Good God Almighty, thank you. Thank you, Brother Pastor. You must be convinced this morning. You must be convinced that the crown gave you access, the privilege, the right to ask and receive the mind of Christ this morning. Hallelujah. You got to be convinced of that. The crown of thorns. You got to be convinced that the piercing in his hands, that this allows you to lay hands on the sick and they can recover, that your hands can be clean and your heart can be pure. Yeah, you got to be convinced of the piercing in his side, good God Almighty, that when the blood ran to water, that your heart too can be converted. Your heart too, hallelujah, can be pierced to love God and submit to God. Your heart too can be circumcised this morning. Yes, you got to be convinced that you got a new heart. You must be convinced this morning that the piercing in his feet gave you the ability, the grace, the power to walk right. You got to be convinced that every stripe by them you are healed. That for the chastisement of our peace, good God Almighty, he took it all. You got to be convinced. You got to be convinced that you are the righteousness of God. Job said, I am convinced in Job chapter 42 that you can do anything, God. You can do anything. You can heal Beth of that kidney disease. You can plant the streams in the land that you have promised. You can do that. You can pack out The men's conference on April the 7th. I'm convinced. I'm convinced this morning. You can help that single woman be found by her godly husband. Because she godly. I'm convinced of that. I'm convinced that you can do supernatural debt cancellation. I'm convinced. I'm convinced that you can grow that person's company and that person's ministry by leaps and bounds because they're faithful to study, they're faithful to pray, they're faithful to keep giving it back to you. I'm convinced. I'm convinced that you can make people put down their guns. I'm convinced that you can turn the heart of number 45 in Washington, D.C. I'm convinced. I'm convinced that nothing is too hard for you. Nothing. Nothing is impossible with you. All things are possible because we believe. I am convinced. What are you convinced about this one? I'm convinced that you can heal, are willing and able to heal my nephew, Jordan Goff, the healed one. Micah, Jordan Micah Goff, the healed one. I am convinced. I'm convinced this morning. Sometimes people tell me, they say, when is the Tate? Or whatever they call me. You just kind of seem like, when you pray sometimes, it's kind of, nonchalant. I said, how about I pray because I'm convinced? How about I pray because I don't pray? I ain't got to beat up the devil. I ain't got to yell and scream at him, and neither do you. You have authority. You do not have to, because I used to, until I understood that any power that the devil has, God has allowed him to have. He can say, stop. I'm convinced that God can stop the hand of the devil. The name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. I keep telling y'all now, you only need the name and the blood. That's all you really need. Ha! Glory to God. The name of Jesus, the word of Jesus, and the blood of Jesus. That's all you need. You don't need a whole bunch. Hey, listen, everything I just named, he's Tiskanu. He's there. He's Nisi, he's the banner. He's Adonai, he's Lord. He's Abba, he's Daddy God. He's Jehovah Rapha. He's Jireh. He's the healer, he's the provider. Whatever you need is summed up all of those Old Testament names. Jehovah, I am healing. I am there. I am Lord. That's what Jehovah means. I am. Whatever you need, I am. All of them names is wrapped up in one name, Jesus. So all you need is the name of Jesus. If you got some scripture in your belly, and if you don't, just open up the word. Just open it up. I tell people all the time, all you got to do is go to Psalms. You just crack open Psalms, you're going to get a good word pretty much every time. Good God Almighty. All you need is the name. All you need is the blood. And all you need is the word. Well, the name is the word. The word is the name. Good God Almighty, because the word is Jesus. Good God Almighty. And the blood is his. Oh, you covered. You got to be convinced this morning. What is it that you need God to do in your life? You got to be convinced. So Job goes on to say, he said, you ask, who is that who questions my wisdom with such ignorance? I've done it. Don't try to act like you ain't. You didn't question God. You didn't question God. That's all you, the blood. That's all you need is the blood, the name of Jesus. If you got some scripture, great. But if not, crack open your Bible. I'll say it again. Ha, the blood. You got to learn how to draw a line. You got to learn how to draw a line, quote unquote, in the sand. Put the blood. That's why the blood goes over your doorpost. That's why you declare the blood over your threshold. Hallelujah. You got people crossing over into the threshold into your house. And that spirit they bring in. Some people you got to let come in. Good God Almighty, till they get delivered. You got to let them come in. So you need to plead the blood over your doorpost, over your threshold. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus will break all of that up. It'll start to break down those generational curses, those generational iniquities. Job said, who's questioning God's wisdom with your ignorance? I tell the story about my spiritual mother, Shirley Alexander, love of the life. Oh my God, I forgot to call her for her birthday. Do it now, as soon as I hang up, as soon as we get off. she said to me one time, we were talking about something I was, this was years ago, probably complaining about. And she said, you know, daughter, she keeps the same tone. You know, daughter, you know, people really think that they know so much about God. And they think they know. She said, but really, what you know could fit in a thimble. And I remember thinking, did she just give me, not today, I would say shade. Did she just shade me? Did she just start with people and now she said me? Because you don't know nothing. You don't know nothing. You don't know nothing compared to God. Paul, David said, your ways are terrible. They're above finding out. Your ways aren't my ways. Your ways are not my ways. How I think something should be done. How you think something should be done. Your ways aren't his ways. Your ways aren't his ways. We got to just recognize that. It's his plan. He created you. He knew you before the foundations of the world. He knows what's best for you. Whether you want to believe it or not. You think you know what's best. But he really does know what's best. You got to be convinced. You got to be convinced. So Job goes on to say, is it I? Was it me talking about things I know nothing about? God asked, who's asking me questions that you don't know nothing about and you being ignorant? So Job had to say, was that me? Kind of like what mother did to me. Did she just give me? Ha ha, glory to God. Let God get you some days that you're like, wait a minute, is he talking to me? When you hear some the pastor say something. Good God Almighty. When you hear something on TV when somebody's talking and they don't want to get at you directly, and I'm not talking about your pastor, because a lot of times they preach it prayerfully what the Spirit of the Lord has told them, and we sitting out there and we like, did I tell him that? Did I text him and tell him that's what was going on with me? Nah, did somebody else tell him, but I ain't told nobody? No, that's the Holy Spirit who trying to get at you. Ha ha, good God Almighty. Job had to ask himself, is God talking about me? Did God just get at me? God goes on to say, listen, let me speak. I have some questions for you, Job. I got some questions for you, Tuesday. I got some questions for all those who are listening and will listen. He said, I got some questions for you. And you better answer. That's scripture. God said, and you better answer. When I ask you, you better. That's like your mama. Did you do? You better answer. You better answer. He said, I had only heard about you before, but now, so Job kind of interrupts God a little bit, and he says, I had only heard about you before, but now I have seen you with my own eyes, and I take back everything I said, and I sit in the dust and ashes that show my repentance. Job was like, wait, before you start asking me, let me just go ahead and repent. let me just go ahead and tell you, I'm sorry, Lord. I'm sorry I was questioning you. I'm sorry. So before God could even get at it, before God could even get at him for good, for real good. Oh, that's what we had to do. So, Mom, I'm sorry. Before they laid that bell on you, before your father hit you with that bell. I'm sorry. That may have let you get what? Glory to God. You may got what? 5 hits instead of 10. 5 licks instead of 10. But this is how it's said in the Message Bible. Job said, I admit I once lived by the rumors of others. I once lived by the rumor of others, but now I know firsthand because I'm convinced. And I've experienced you with my own eyes, and I've heard you with my own ears, God. It's not what my mama said. It's not what my grandmother said. It's not just what my pastor said. It's not all the people I listen to and watch on Facebook and Instagram and Periscope. It's not who the people I heard on TV. I'm convinced because I have experienced you for myself. I am convinced that I have heard you for myself. I am convinced because I woke up this morning. I woke up in my right mind. I woke up in my good health. I'm going to call you good health. He said, above all, I wish that you would prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers. Your obedience to get up and be on here with me at 5 o'clock in the morning Is your soul prospering? And he said, above all, the word says, I wish that you would be in good health, even as your soul prospers. This is your soul prospering this morning, because the word is good for training, correcting, rebuking, training in righteousness. And that is what you're doing this way. So claim the word of God. Be convinced that when you put the word of God on a situation, God will move, because you're putting Jesus on it. You're putting Jesus on it. So there has to be a move. Yes, yes, it needs to be based in your faith. But whether it's little faith or great faith, or the gift is for other people. Your gift of faith ain't even got nothing to do with you. That's for you to use with other people. But your personal faith, mustard seed, little, great, and everything in between. He said, I've never seen greater faith. Yeah, yeah. You got to be convinced this morning. And if you know you have questioned God, listen, because I ain't tripping on nobody questioning God. Jesus questioned God. Job questioned God. Who else questioned God? Paul, Peter, they questioned him. God ain't tripping on you questioning him, but what's your motive behind questioning him? Are you questioning because you think you know better, like Job did and his friends? They thought they knew how it should go. They thought they knew what the answer would be. They thought they were telling God, you don't know what you're talking about. God, you wrong. We right. See, what's your motive behind questioning God? God is not tripping on you questioning him. It's your motive. It's what's in your heart. Are you questioning? It's the thing I used to say, I have said, I don't know if I've said it in a while, but when God allowed me to be over, well, anyway, I won't say that. When I was in a season where I had to speak into other leaders' lives and work on different things with leaders, and they would question why their pastor was doing certain things. And I said, so are you questioning because you want to understand? Are you questioning because you're uncertain? Are you questioning because you're losing hope? Or are you questioning because you think you know what's better? Because we never did it like this before. Or why are we doing it like that? Or why is Pastor... So what's your motive for questioning? Good morning, sister. Good morning, Sister Yvette. Good morning, Sister Amanda. Amanda. Good morning, Sister Shmur. Good morning. Why are you questioning God? That's... God is not tripping on you. Jesus said, God, if it's possible, can you take this cup from me? God didn't answer. he didn't respond, but he didn't mind. He wasn't tripping on Jesus asking him questions. Paul, three times the Bible said, Paul asked him to take this from me. But so did Jesus. Jesus asked three times in the garden. God is not tripping on you asking him why. He's not tripping. But what's your motive for asking him why? We saw here in Job chapter 42, God was getting ready to let Job have it. He was getting ready to, he said, let me just listen. Let me talk. God said, wait a minute, let me talk. And that's something that you can have, that type of relationship with God, that there's dialogue. You can have that through the Holy Spirit. You can have that through the word of God. When you're reading, when you're studying, the Holy Spirit will speak back to you when you see something, like when I saw this yesterday. Job chapter 42, verses 1 through 6. I'm convinced that you, God, this is what I know. I know that I know that I know that God can do anything but fail. I know that I know that I know that God can do anything, and nothing can stand against him. Nothing can stop God. Nothing can stop God. What is it that you are desiring to accomplish in your life and you've given it to God? First of all, you believe God told you that that's his will for your life. You believe that God has spoken to you this promise. You got to be convinced. You got to be convinced. You got to walk around with your head up high and your shoulders back, knowing that you are blessed and highly favored. Be convinced this morning. You got to be convinced. You got to be convinced that if you are doing your best, and I'm going to say it like this, to walk uprightly before the Lord, you must be convinced. If you are trying to treat people right and you are trying to do the right thing, you must be convinced that God is going to fight your battle. He will fight your battle in court. He will fight your battle at work. He will fight your battle in that relationship. He will fight your battle in your finances. He will fight your battle in your health. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. Give it to him. Give it to him. Give it to him. God will, that is like, give it to him and quit taking it back. Quit taking it back. Quit picking it up. Quit picking it up now. I'm not saying that you doing your research and you having the right information and you going to do, you know, God promised you that you're going to have X, Y, and Z. Well, whatever you need to do personally to achieve that, do it. But don't get ahead of God. Don't try to get ahead of God. Don't try to catch the Ark of the Covenant and put your hand on something God ain't told you to put your hand on. Get your hand back. That ain't for you to touch. Pray for their soul. Pray for their salvation. Get your mouth off of them. Good God Almighty. Quit complaining. I'm going to say it. Shut up. Jesus. Hush your mouth. Quiet your spirit. As our Pastor Carol says, just quiet yourself. Quiet yourself. You got to be convinced this morning that God will fight your battles. What's your battle this morning? Is it that wayward child? Oh, do what you're supposed to do. Discipline them. If you still are into laying hands and whooping, do it. That's the Bible. Spare the rod, spoil the child. Whatever you are to do according to this word, you do it. But anything beyond that, give it to God. And even what you're doing, the part that you're doing, keep giving it to God. God, I called. I'm looking for a job. I went there. I remember a young man was like, my mom keeps telling me I need to go look for a job. But people don't go into buildings and places and fill out applications to look for jobs unless you're going into Burger King or McDonald's. I said, that's true. They don't. They do go online. You come in to a building and say, I'm wondering if you guys are hiring. They're going to give you a number. They're going to give you something, a website. So do what you need to do, but get up off that couch and go look for a job. Do your part, whether you're looking for it on your website, on the internet, however you're doing it, do it. Do it. Do it. And God will honor that. Job goes on to say that God says, I will accept Job's prayers. Even though Job had questioned God, even though he said in his ignorance, he questioned God. God said, I'm going to bless Job. I'm going to receive his prayers. Let's read it. After Job, in verse, this is still 42, verse 10. The Bible says, after Job had interceded for his friends. Y'all should know the story. Job's friends was talking smack. Two of them. One was, he was on point. But they was talking smack. And so Job prayed for them. He prayed for them. Pray for the people who talking smack. About what you ain't gonna do. What you can't do. You doing too much. Why you gotta do that? Who told you to do that? God said that? For real? God talked to you? Shut up. Pray for him. Yep, God talked to me. God told me to do that. And in obedience to him, I'm gonna do it. And I'm gonna give it back to him. Because it's his plan anyway. The plans of man are nothing. You must. Walk in the obedience of God. He says in verse 11, Job prays for him. God restores Job's fortune and gives him back double. You got to be convinced this morning. God ain't giving double back to nobody ain't convinced. He's not. You can't be wavering. You can't be lukewarm. He ain't giving double back to nobody that's lukewarm. He said he gonna spew you out. Blah. I said it. What is he doing? What for? What, so the double can be wasted? He ain't giving you back double. You don't even believe like that. You're not convinced. Quit. God gonna give me double for my trouble. You complain the whole time you in trouble. And did you get yourself in trouble? Or did somebody else get you in trouble? If somebody else gave you in trouble, got you in trouble, okay. Lord, get me out of this. You got yourself in trouble. Lord, forgive me for putting myself in this. Job said he had to look at himself and say, was that me? Was that me? Did I do that? Did I cause that? Did I cause the tears that I'm tasting? Was that my decision that put me in this situation? I had choices and I made this decision. Ah, but his grace is sufficient. You got to be convinced of that. His grace is sufficient. That in your weakness, you can be made strong. You got to be convinced of that. You got to be convinced that your obedience can stop the disobedience of others. You got to be convinced of that. That's the word. God says in his word that he gives Job back double. And all of his brothers and sisters and friends came to his house to celebrate. And they told him how sorry they were for the trouble that he had to face. God is going to make people come back to you and say they're sorry for the trouble they caused. Not just the trouble that God allowed. Oh my God, I hear this. I hear this. When you stay steadfast in God and people don't understand why you still going to church, why you still going to that church, why you still serving that pastor, why you still bringing your tithes, why you still believing God, why you still with that man, why you still with that woman, but God turns that thing around. Now you got a loving husband that loves you the way that Christ loved the church. Now you got a wife that can submit to you as unto the Lord because you're following Christ. My God Almighty, why are you still praying for that N-I-G-G-A? Yeah, somebody that said it. Why are you still doing it? Why are you still believing God for that? You ain't got a head yet. That didn't mean you nothing. Listen, God wants you to understand you're good. God is going to count your good. God is going to count your good. God is going to count the fact that you did not give up, that you did not put your hand to the plow and look back, that you did not shrink back. God is going to honor your good. God is going to honor your good, and he's going to make somebody. He's going to make people come back and say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that that happened to you. I'm sorry that I was a part of that happening to you. I'm sorry that I did that to you. Oh my God, but you stay faithful. You stay faithful. You, I know it's hard to speak well of people that didn't stab you in the back. I know it's hard to speak well of haters. I know it's hard to speak well of people who don't mean you no good. I know it's hard to speak well of that spouse who didn't slap you. I know. I know it's hard to speak well of that woman that you in a relationship with or married to that dog you out and tell you you ain't nothing. I know it's hard to speak well of that husband or that boyfriend who tell, well, let me tell you something about boyfriends and girlfriends who dogging you out. You know what? You have the right to step. Let me just stop right there. Why are you putting up with a boyfriend or a girlfriend talking crazy to you? They ain't your husband. They ain't your wife. I get that you staying with a spouse. I get that. But we've been together 5 years. Well, 5 years since he ain't married you yet. Girl, boo. Boo. Annie dogging you? Or she dogging you? Nah, you can go. Peace, two fingers. For real. Now, back to husbands and wives. You waiting on God to change your spouse. You waiting on God to save him. You waiting on God to touch his heart, to touch your heart. Well, God will do it. And they will come back. They will come back and say, I'm sorry. This is the word. This is the word. Now, you ain't got to hold your breath. You just keep doing and walking in life and doing what God has told you to do. And you will look up and there they are calling your phone. There they are knocking on your door. There they are sending you an inbox message. You know what? I just want to tell you. Anybody other than me? Then had it happen. Yeah. Yeah, God is faithful. He's faithful and he can turn. You got to be convinced that God can turn the hearts of kings. He can turn the stony heart into a heart of flesh. God can touch the people that need to be touched in your life. He can speak to the one that knows your gift, that knows your talent, that knows your ability, that knows what you have need of. And they will call you and say, listen, I heard you need X, Y, and Z. God will drop in your spirit who you need to call, who you need to text, who you need to email to say, hey, I'm looking for X, Y, and Z. How can you help me? How can you direct me? You got to be convinced this morning. I need you. Somebody hashtag that. Be convinced. I don't need a t-shirt that says that. Be convinced. You got to be convinced that nothing's going to separate you. You got to be convinced that God is all-knowing, all-powerful, all-wise. You got to be convinced this morning. You got to be convinced that as you go out today and go out the rest of this week until we come back together next week, that whatever you are asking God for, God is faithful to do. Thank you for the hearts. That's how we praise God. Give him glory through your hearts and your likes. Be convinced this morning. Hashtag be convinced. Goes on to say in Job chapter 42, God blesses Job in the latter parts of his life where he's giving him double. He gets his kids back. He gets his finances back. He gets his livestock back because Job stayed faithful to God, even in his running his mouth, even in him in his distress. Listen, I keep telling you now, I want you to hear me. In your distress and in your frustration and in your weariness, God knows you're going to say things you shouldn't say. He knows that. Be convinced. Thank you, Sister Yvette. Be convinced. Be convinced. Tell somebody in your life, you got to be convinced. You got to be convinced of what God promised you. God is not tripping when you, the Bible says, don't grow weary in your well-doing. There is a due season if you faint not. Job didn't faint. He said, I won't faint. He said, I won't. He said, I won't. Though he slay me, I ain't gonna faint. I'm not gonna turn from God. His wife told him to turn from him. Glory to God. No, God said, Job said, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna turn from God. I will not faint because I'm convinced. Now, let's be clear. This is the end of Job's story. Job chapter 42. That's where Job says, I'm convinced. We done went from all the way, good God Almighty, chapter 1 through 41. 1 through 41. It is at 42. There's a place in your life that we all come to that we must be convinced. Good morning, Sands. There is a place that we all come to that we must be convinced. Job went through hell. And that's why he was able to say, I've seen you for myself. I've heard you for myself. And I'm convinced. You got to be convinced this morning. I don't know if it's required for you to go through hell, for you to have to face this and have to face that and have to deal with this and have to deal with that. I'm encouraging you this morning to just be convinced. Be convinced that God will never leave you. He'll never forsake you. That nothing will separate you from him. Be convinced that he who began a good work in you has promised to complete it until the returning of the Lord. Be convinced that God has a purpose and a plan for you. Be convinced. Be convinced that he who promises is faithful. Be convinced. Be convinced that what he has promised you, he will do. It will come to pass. Be convinced. If God has promised you single women, a husband, and you've been living your life waiting in vain, in that vain, not waiting in vain, but waiting in that vain, V-A-N-E, he's going to do it. Single man, if God has promised to send you a wife, and we're certainly believing godly spouses, he's going to do it. He's going to lead your feet right to the woman that God has for you. Be convinced. If he's promised you for supernatural debt cancellation so that you owe nobody nothing but love, because that's what's written, that's what's in this word. God, in your word says that I should owe nobody nothing but love, so I'm looking for supernatural debt cancellation. Not so that I can buy another pair of shoes or buy a fancy car or buy a big old 5,000 square foot home and it's only just me. unless you getting ready to move people in, okay? Be convinced. He don't mind you having the big house. He don't mind you having the fancy car. He don't mind you having another pair of fancy shoes and a sharp 3-button-down, 5-button-down, single button suit. He really ain't tripping on that. But it is he who gives us the power to gain wealth, to establish his kingdom. So God, you said that if I obey, there's some promises to me. I'm convinced of that. So Lord, we thank you. And we love you this morning. We are convinced. We are convinced of your word. We are convinced of your love. We are convinced of your truth. We are convinced this morning that you sit high and you look low. We are convinced that you are our God. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Daddy God. Thank you, Daddy God. We are convinced this morning. God, we thank you that we can pray with conviction. We can pray with confidence. We can pray with faith. We can stand on your word because we are convinced today that nothing can stand against you. That all things are possible because we believe. That nothing is impossible because we believe. I am convinced that the call on my life will be fulfilled. Though it will come with challenges, though it will come with critique, though it may cost me something, I'm convinced this morning that you who began a good work in me has promised to complete it. I'm convinced this morning. I'm convinced that the plans that you've given me and the plans that you have me will come to pass. They will prosper. The vision that you've shown me will be made manifest. I'm convinced. And I pray that you heard the word of the Lord this morning. And you can go out throughout your day and your week. And as you get more word, you too can be convinced. Amen. Amen. Join me on April the 7th for the Father for Men's Conference. We are, good morning, Sister Tracy. We are still looking for churches to sponsor, 20 churches to sponsor 10 men and send them, amen, get them to sign up and put their name on it and send those 10 men, 2010, that's what we're looking for, 20 churches to send 10 men, and that will put 200 men in the house, and it will be well worth God's labor that he's charged me to do this. And so I pray that any pastor that hears this, I think I have 2 or 3 pastors that are sending men, and not just sending the check. Thank you for the check. But we need the men, because to have the sponsors and to have the people so into it and to have the facilitators and dynamic workshop topics is of no gain. Amen. Our kingdom does not gain. Our church does not gain. Our community does not gain. Our marriages and our family and our children do not gain if the men are not in the house. But I'm convinced. I'm convinced that those men are going to be sitting in the sanctuary. I'm convinced. Anybody convinced with me, believe with me that God will send our men, and our men will bring their teenage sons and their nephews and their grandsons in the name of Jesus. And so if you sponsor teens, send teens. Glory to God. So we this is the vision that God has given me. It's not my plan. So I'm convinced that the plan that God has given me for the Father for Men's Conference presented by Opportune Indy will come to pass, and it will be glorious. That Bishop Sapp will come with a word that will set the men on fire. That Dr. Hampton, Pastor Hampton, is going to open up and lay it out and open it up so they can go into their workshops. It is going to be a glorious day. Thank you to those who have offered to volunteer. Tracy, you up for volunteering on Saturday, April the 27th? Inbox me, let me know. And so just looking for women to help serve lunch, serve breakfast, make sure that the men know where their workshops are. But in the actual breakouts and in the sanctuary where ministry is going on, women will not be allowed until 2:00. And at that time, we will do the restoration reconciliation ceremony where men will stand in the gap to say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for what happened to you. Will you forgive me? So it is going to be a powerful, powerful day. And I'm just believing God for what he has promised will come to pass. You know, I sometimes look at Paul and I look at Moses and I'm like, who really would want to deal with 1 million, but about 3 million people? Moses, really? And then write the first 5 books of the Bible? Do y'all really think he wanted to do that? No, he was being obedient to God. Do you really think Paul wanted to write 13 books of the Bible? Do you really think he wanted to be shipwrecked and bit by a snake and beaten and put in jail? Do you really think he wanted to do that? He was being obedient to God. Hallelujah. And so I seek to be. Good morning, Sister Terry. Hey, are you available on April the 7th? Inbox me, let me know about serving at the men's conference. And tell Brother Raymond he need to be there. He played too much. Hallelujah. And so we love God today. We love the Lord. And I pray that you have a blessed day. I pray that this word has been active, has been imparted, and has been released into your life. We love you. God bless you. Have a great day.